patients first diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis, one of their main questions is, how are we going to treat this? How am I going to be feeling better? And there are several ways to treat rheumatoid arthritis. We try to use medications that we call disease-modifying drugs. And what we mean by that is that they change the course of the disease. They prevent erosions in the joints and permanent damage. And these are key medications to get started early in rheumatoid arthritis so our patients don't have that permanent damage in their joints. Within this category of medications, these disease-modifying medications, there are two main subcategories. So there are conventional oral disease-modifying medications, and there are biologic disease-modifying medications. Often people will start first with the conventional oral medications to treat their rheumatoid arthritis. And so some examples of these medications are sulfasalazine, methotrexate, and leflunomide. And these medications work by modulating the immune system so that it's not as active damaging the joints as it normally is in rheumatoid arthritis. And these medications have been used for decades in rheumatoid arthritis. They're generally well tolerated. There are some side effects for the particular medications that need to be considered. We need to always watch out for side effects when we're starting any new medication. When you're on these types of medications, the main thing to know is that your blood work will need to be monitored regularly. And this is to make sure that the liver functions are normal and that the blood counts all stay normal with these types of medications. There's not a big increased risk of infection with these types of medications. Some do not increase the risk of infection at all, so that's a plus for this category of medications. So the fact that these medications are oral or available by pills you take by mouth, that's attractive to a lot of patients as opposed to injections or infusions like some of the biologic medication. So we'll often start patients with a conventional disease-modifying drug before going to a biologic drug. And these medications, besides having been around longer, end up being less expensive, and often there's less trouble with insurance of getting these medications approved and paid for. So the other main class of medications to improve outcomes in rheumatoid arthritis are biologic disease-modifying drugs. This class is ever-expanding. New drugs are coming on the market, but the main categories are TNF inhibitors, drugs that block an inflammatory protein called TNF, abatacept, which is a drug that helps prevent T cells from becoming too activated, tocilizumab, which is a drug that blocks a pro-inflammatory protein and that causes inflammation, IL-6. Rituximab, which works on the B cells. The biologic drugs, the first ones approved were TNF inhibitors, and that's about 20 years ago. So we've been using some of these as long as 2 decades for the treatment of rheumatoid arthritis. The TNF inhibitors are only available in injection or infusion form. These medications work by turning down the immune responses that are too active in RA, so turning the dial down on your immune system. And so as a result, one of the main things that we think about is the risk of infection. Our immune system normally is supposed to protect us from outside invaders, bacteria, viruses. And so when we start turning down the immune system, we do somewhat increase the risk of infection. So before you would start a TNF inhibitor, your rheumatologist will check you for hepatitis, viral hepatitis, and also for tuberculosis to make sure that you don't have a chronic infection that could then come to the surface as a result of being started on these drugs. And while you're on these drugs, if any signs of infection develop, like fevers or productive coughing up stuff to suggest pneumonia, urinary tract symptoms, skin infections, anything of that sort, these drugs will potentially be held while you're treated for those infections so that you can heal and get back on track. And that's true in general for the biologics, using the TNF inhibitors as an example. These drugs classes can often be combined, conventional oral disease-modifying drugs with biologic drugs. The oral drugs can be combined together themselves as well. Sometimes biologic drugs are used on their own. There are many different treatment options. So when I have a patient who's diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis and they hear it's a chronic disease that we don't yet cure, they're often understandably upset by this diagnosis. But I like to reassure people that in 2017, we have so many great treatment options for rheumatoid arthritis, and we can really manage the disease well and help people achieve their goals and stay functional. An infusion is a medication that's given directly into the vein. So to have an infusion, patients will go to an infusion center or a clinic. They'll have an IV started, so an IV catheter put into their vein, usually into their arm, and then the medication will be given directly into the IV. The good thing about infusion type medications is that compared to some medications which have to be injected by the patient or a family member at home, they are going to a healthcare setting and they don't have to do anything. They can just sit back and let the nurses there take care of them and give them the infusion. The downside of that is that they must then go and make an appointment and take time out of their day to have the infusions done versus injection medications, which can be done at home by the patient or by family or friends. Infusions are often given with pre-medications to prevent any bad reactions. So patients will often receive Tylenol and Benadryl and sometimes even steroids before they get their infusion to make sure that everything goes smoothly. Infusions often are given more frequently up front and then spaced out. They are dosed by body weight, which is nice compared to other types of medications, which are more one-size-fits-all dosing. So infusions are good options for treating rheumatoid arthritis and other forms of autoimmune disease that we see in rheumatology. And to find out if that's right for you, talk to your rheumatologist.